This is Kate Beckinsale. You're listening to BaconScience.
In the year 2019, Popeyes introduced a fried chicken sandwich to its menu. They were not prepared for the results. After a series of back-and-forth tweets between Popeyes and their main poultry competitor, Chick-fil-A, public demand skyrocketed, causing chaos, violence, bloodshed, and rising cholesterol numbers across the land. And thus began the chicken sandwich wars.
Welcome to BaconScience. I'm Joel.
I'm Kent.
And I'm Jacob.
Hey! Jacob, we missed you.
Hey, it has been a long time imitating Zach. I am so glad to be back.
Really good impression.
Confession, guys, there actually is no Zach. Jacob, put on a beard.
Save it for the season finale.
We want to release these things in August.
Yeah, no, Jacob's back, and welcome back, Jacob.
Hey, thanks.
Welcome back, Jake. Have you prepared for this show?
Yeah, obviously.
Why would you say that to Jake?
It's because what the few past me said, future me had to say. We're glad you're here and glad you're filling in for Zach, who's off. And we had a wonderful catch up with Jacob on our Pacon bit.
Yeah, it's like 45 minutes long. No big deal.
But yeah,
that was fun.
Yeah. And so we talked about a lot of the stuff there. So if you want to know what's going on in Jacob's life, you can go check it out on patreon.com, because that's where we had our little, that was like our first conversation we've had like that.
Yeah, true. That's pretty great.
Yeah. And in fact, speaking of Patreon, we have a new patron.
Woo-hoo!
Heather Pease. Heather Pease is a $3 patron, which means she gets access to these extra episodes of BaconScience that we do on patreon.com. And thank you, Heather, for that. We really do appreciate it. And all you patrons, really do appreciate it. You help keep the lights here on in the Bacon Cave.
And thank you for listening to our last episode, Ask BaconScience Again.
Yes. I was going to say it was an unusual episode.
It was.
In that it was a little bit serious at times.
Wait, was it? It was Ask BaconScience ... Again?
Yes.
Yeah.
It exactly was.
That's embarrassing.
You know, we needed a show idea.
That's like a Nicolas Cage movie title.
Wait till the next Ask BaconScience.
Yeah.
No, we got some feedback. Scott on Twitter said, maybe it wasn't as funny as the dolphin sounds, but Kenny D's impression of Shaggy at the 1250 mark just came out as a moan, and I laughed until I was physically weak. So funny.
I don't think I intended to do a moan impression.
It's just like a...
You can't help yourself.
No matter what
sound I make, it just sounds like a moan.
I went out and listened to it. It made me laugh pretty hard.
Oh, no.
That was funny.
Also, we have a comment from Christine Western on Instagram. She said, Joel is the circ guy. Kent is absolutely going to the Backstreet Show, and Zach will be gambling.
Wow.
I love these questions, and the answers are so fun.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Which Zach's mom said.
Yeah, said he'd be gambling.
Apparently, that's what she thinks.
Jake, do you remember Joel gambling all the time?
No, just Zach.
Oh, just Zach. Yeah.
And Zach's mom.
Yeah.
Joel gambling?
Joel used to gamble a lot.
No,
he did?
I did
not. With our hearts.
That is such a rumor. But no, thank you for your comments. We enjoyed doing it, and we hope you enjoyed getting a little more insight into us. But that's not what we're talking about.
He always told me craps wasn't gambling.
It's because I wasn't talking about the game, Jacob. What are we talking about today, Jacob?
Hey, today we are talking about... I had to do it just for you. Chicken sandwiches.
Yeah,
and you know what? It was almost listener, a bacon episode.
Yes, Jacob.
On BaconScience.
We talked to Jacob a few months back. When was that? A long time ago.
Yeah, I messaged you guys.
May or
and
June.
I was like, hey, yeah. I have a kind of show idea that I cannot believe hasn't happened.
Early this year, he says, I want to do a bacon show. And we started working on it. And then Jacob went, bacon's going to be around forever. Chicken sandwich is the hot topic right now.
Yeah, it really is the new hotness.
Yeah.
Well, a year ago, it was the new hotness. That's
yeah, it's
usually
still around.
No, that's my cycle. Hey, it was cool a year ago. I think it's time.
Yes.
Right.
So we are going to be doing a ranking, a scientific BaconScience ranking of chicken sandwiches. Now, we've done shows like this before, such as episode 61, where we ranked pizza chains back in June of 2016.
Wow.
And then we did episode 146, Lord of the Fries. Back in March of 2018. And then two years ago in episode 216, Love Me Tenders and Nuggets. That was in August of 2019.
How are we not dead?
I think it's because we only eat greens and fresh veggies in between these challenges.
I'm sure. A steady diet of Wendy's.
I have a lot of like health conscious friends now, and it's like, you're really doing that?
Yeah,
and
you ate the whole menu?
Listen, let's not talk about it, okay? It happened, and it's okay.
Yeah,
I'm alive.
We didn't. I was going to say, Jacob, you weren't on the Subway show. Do you have strong opinions about Subway?
You know what that reminds me of, Joel? Is a conversation I actually had with Kent one time. And I said to Kent, hey, do you know what's good at Subway? And he says, what? Right? And I say, everything. You know what's great at Subway? And he goes, what? And I said, nothing.
That sounds about right.
Yeah, yeah. That was our experience.
Yeah, yeah, that was it.
And
it
but was there like, were some real bad.
Really bad?
Some real
there was
bad.
Some real bad. But here's the thing, Jacob, you may not have known. Mm-hmm. Like a couple weeks after our episode aired, Subway must have listened because they revamped their entire menu.
Oh, Subway, thank you for finally giving us some credit here.
Yeah. 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 All the other challenges we did, they didn't do that. But let's jump back to chicken sandwiches, okay, if we will. So just to give you a little history of chicken sandwiches, Chick-fil-A claims that it invented the fried chicken sandwich in the 1940s. And then they, around 1960s, when they kind of started mass marketing the first chicken sandwich that was introduced by a popular restaurant chain. So while it's disputed whether they invented the chicken sandwich.
I'm sure some diner started it.
But they didn't invent the chicken sandwich. Someone put chicken in between some bread at
right.
some point.
I know. I ran out of hamburger meat. Here's so that, chicken.
That's yeah. debatable, but they are most likely the first chicken sandwich introduced by a fast food restaurant chain.
Okay.
What we want to talk about primarily today is the Great Chicken Sandwich Wars.
We invented it. Yeah. We invented eating. Basically. It was us. No one did it before.
The Chicken Sandwich Wars actually has its own Wikipedia page, and it says it began in 2019 and as of 2021, we're ongoing.
People have actually been stabbed over this war.
We're having a show about it, so it is ongoing.
Yeah, and like I said at the beginning of this episode, so Popeyes introduced a chicken sandwich to its menu. And they kind of touted it as like the coolest thing ever, to which Chick-fil-A replied and basically said, yeah, but we're the original. And it was this back and forth. Wikipedia calls it a tete-a-tete.
So as Popeyes, they came out and the word of mouth for this sandwich was huge because it was $3.99.
Right.
Popeyes gets out there and doesn't even have as huge a Twitter following as Chick-fil-A.
No.
But they're like, hey, have you tried our new sandwich? Which, by the way, sold out in 2 weeks. And then Chick-fil-A's yes. like, oh, hey, wait a minute. Bow before the king.
No.
Not the Burger King, because we were the first ones to go.
Yeah.
And I'm saying this because they are legitimately the first, the most well-known chicken sandwich out there.
Yes.
And so then they just start roasting mm-hmm. each other. And Wendy's getting all cocky because we've talked about Wendy's Twitter feed.
Yeah.
Wendy's was basically like, oh, it's so cute when you guys fight over second place. And it's like,
yeah, right, Wendy's.
Yeah,
we'll
it's
talk.
Cute, Wendy's.
Yeah, yeah, it's cute.
But here's the funny thing is that when they announced that they were doing these sandwiches, mm-hmm. they weren't expecting what was going to happen. They saw a 38% increase in their sales, and most of it was because of the chicken sandwich. And so they started running out.
Yeah.
And they started running out of supplies.
Oh, they were legit running out
to the point where they had a promotion, and I'm not making this up, called Bring Your Own Bun.
No, we experienced this. Do you remember at work?
Yes.
Yeah.
And so, like, that was a thing where they I guess the problem was they didn't have enough buns for chicken sandwiches, which seems like the easy part.
Yes.
Lots of chicken, no buns.
Yeah. But it got to the point where people were fighting over these chicken sandwiches, fighting employees and fighting each other. There has literally been fatalities related to people having fights at Popeye's Chicken.
Really sad.
Like, standing in line, like, no, you can't
drive through.
Yeah, I was here first. You yeah. cut. How uh-huh. dare you? And I'm like, for a chicken sandwich?
Like that movie Falling Down with Michael Douglas?
But with chicken sandwiches.
It's basically that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But there's been stabbings and shootings and fist fights. Like, it's been chaotic.
We've only been involved with a fraction of those.
Yeah. And exactly.
Us personally?
Just yeah, the stabbings. Exactly. Only the stabbings. Baconsale only does stabbings. But the employees talked about how exhausted they were. They were working 60-hour work weeks. They were getting yelled at all the time. Yeah,
they
were
open longer than they were supposed to be? Or just making chicken?
No,
or?
I actually saw signs. It was like, we're out of chicken sandwiches. Please don't yell at us.
Yeah.
Oh.
Which is ridiculous. Why are people so stupid about a fast food item?
It's a good sandwich.
It was $3.99 and it was delicious.
It's 15 cents less than a Chick-fil-A sandwich.
But you've seen how people line up for these new fast food places. Imagine a brand new mm-hmm, fast food mm-hmm. item that's good.
Well,
it's getting that kind of word of mouth.
The funniest thing to me is just how Popeyes ran out of their supply.
Yeah.
Fights are happening all over the place. And we know Chick-fil-A's like, my pleasure, and giving chicken sandwiches to everyone that comes there. Like, they didn't even blink.
So basically, the Popeye sandwich was the toilet paper of the year previous.
I didn't see it run out from Chick-fil-A, at least in my research, I didn't. Mm. But the funny thing is that other fast food brands started seeing this.
20 other
and fast jumping food on the back. Yeah, by January 2021, more than 20 American fast food brands had introduced newer, updated
and
chicken sandwiches.
This was the impetus for the show idea. Is I was like, okay, Carl's Jr. is doing this. Yes. Burger King is doing this. KFC has like a new hand breaded thing. It was like, okay, this is everyone's copying. Let's actually rank them.
Yeah. And so that became the thing where like everyone's doing a chicken sandwich now. And I've also heard, and this is just me kind of doing my Joel research here.
Is that the sound for Joel research now?
Yeah.
But a lot's changed, Jake.
Yeah. So I do it every time. Trust me. But that it was because to feed a cow, to raise a cow, takes a lot of land and a lot of resources. Mm-hmm. It is much cheaper for them to do it, to put chicken sandwiches
out
there.
We can kill 10 chickens for every quarter of a cow.
That's real sad.
No, but that's the whole point where like it's cheaper for them to raise and harvest chickens than cows. Mm-hmm. And so all these fast food restaurants who primarily did burgers are like, let's go this way because that's the hot thing right
now.
Do
you feel like you can taste the quality of care they put into these chickens?
Dude, I actually had a thought where I was like, oh, I'm driving to go get another chicken sandwich I don't want. I'm so sick of chicken sandwiches. I can't believe I'm killing a chicken just so I can do this right now.
Oh, yeah.
Jacob, you don't have to kill him yourself to get the sandwich.
Oh, you know where he was raised, though.
So, wait. Popeye's like, bring your own bun. Jacob's bringing his own chicken. Can you fry this up?
Here's the chicken.
Should I cut the head off now?
You want to kill it here or do you kill it in the back?
Listen, the important part is their batter, okay? So, obviously I'm going to have,
This is getting dark.
A free-range chicken I brought myself. Are you guys savages?
Honestly, probably delicious.
Yeah, exactly.
What do you put in your batter, Jacob?
No. That's for the restaurants. Oh. They do the batter. I bring the chicken. Okay.
That makes sense.
Obviously.
That makes sense.
What have you guys been doing?
So you just walk up to the counter with a chicken without its head and you just pluck. Put this in your batter.
They run around for a while. You got to wait.
Yeah. Oh, this is dark.
Anyway, so if you're hungry now, wait till later. So we've taken...
It makes for a great restaurant scene. Yeah. You just drop them right in the middle.
So we've taken 15 different restaurants and we've eaten all the chicken sandwiches at these restaurants. Mm-hmm. And when we say all the chicken sandwiches, we mean it's usually the premium crispy sandwich. We didn't do spicy. We didn't do grilled. We just did the crispy sandwich as a comparison.
A lot of these were pre-existing sandwiches that we've talked about at fast food places before on some of our menu challenges. But a lot were created to replicate Chick-fil-A and Popeyes.
Yeah, some of them feel like a real knockoff.
Yeah.
By the way, the restaurants we went to 100%. In alphabetical order are Arby's, Arctic Circle, Burger King, Carl's Jr., Chick-fil-A, Culver's, Dairy Queen, KFC, McDonald's, Popeyes, Raising Cane's, Shake Shack, Sonic Drive-In, Wendy's, and Zaxby's.
We have a real itch for diabetes, guys.
Does diabetes come from saturated fat?
Yeah, carbs.
We chose 13 fast food places and then in the last couple days added two extra ones. In fact, at the 11th hour, one was brought to the table and I was so angry because I got it at 10 o'clock last night.
But you did it just before. Yeah. I was like, I'm done. Ha ha. Oh, by the way, I won again, guys. I creamed you two.
Did you? Oh, no. I added another one on the way and then I finished it. So I'm actually the one.
No, let's bring this back. Joel created the list for this show and I was like, cool, I need to get started. Joel was going out of town, Jake.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And so you and I had 2.5 weeks to complete this challenge. Joel had already finished, which means in 8 days in his prep, he had eaten 13 chicken sandwiches.
Oh my gosh. Now, what I did, and I think this was the smart way to do it. I might do this later because
I'm listening.
Before when I'd eat, I was usually eating a vacuum where it's like the one sandwich, I'd eat it and I'd go with that. This time I got 2 chicken sandwiches per day for a while there and I'd eat them side by side. I let my family have bites too, so it wasn't me eating the whole thing, thank goodness. But I ate way too much. But I would eat one and then eat the other and have this. It was a nice comparison to have the comparison between the two. I do have a confession to make to you though, gentlemen.
Go on.
Because even though I won, and then we added Dairy Queen, and I won again.
Yes.
I thought of Sonic the next day around lunchtime. I all of a sudden, I was like, oh, no, we forgot Sonic. And so I was
everyone forgets Sonic.
So, but I didn't want to tell you guys right then because I didn't want you to get one before me.
Because I would have got it.
I waited. When I texted you guys.
You work really hard to win a game that you're the only one playing at.
When I messaged you guys and I said, oh, crap, Sonic, I was literally in line.
Because
and I'd ordered my
the
meal
the day before,
Sonic.
I went to a Popeyes as my final sandwich. That's and so a funny. Sonic was right next door. So if you told me. Oh
yeah,
we might have another competition just so I can beat you at this, which I would have done.
No, until
I
knew the ones that he just goes to.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
I think Jacob and you said you outsourced all your eating to an intern or something like that.
Tell me what it tastes like.
Chew it up and spit in my mouth. I don't have time.
The chewing is so hard.
Well, it is sometimes. Let's be honest.
Oh, that is true. Some of these that sandwiches. Is true.
But we created our BaconScience matrix, which you can actually see. It's proprietary information, but if you're a patron, you can see our matrix. Our scoring.
Very scientific.
And at patreon.baconscience.com.
Actually, somebody at my work saw our spreadsheet and was like, what is this?
it's scientific.
I like, actually, man, it's no joke.
It's old habits.
So we have compiled scores. We're going to go from worst to first. Sorry, we have spent so much time talking about the background. And we can give our personal rankings as we go, but let's give our thoughts and impressions. And
we rank these on overall taste.
Yes.
Chicken and breading. Bun quality.
Ladies.
Family friendly. Sauce and toppings and rebuyability.
Yeah.
Those are the criteria that we were ranking on.
This is good criteria.
So, yeah, we're going to go from worst to first and let you know definitively, according to BaconScience, what are the worst and the best chicken sandwiches
now,
available.
I might add, listener, that Bacon Science really works because when you aggregate three perfect opinions, let me say it like this,
okay.
Almost perfect opinions, you get the perfect formula.
I agree.
You really do. Because when I saw the final thing, I was like, yeah, okay.
Well, and even when I was putting in scores, I'd put in a score and then I saw it ranked and I'm like, really?
Because we disagree on some of these.
Well, I mean, I just kind of averages.
We do, but
I put in the scores for one, and it was like dead last. And I was like, did I really hit that one that much? And I went, would I eat it again? No.
Mm-mm.
But so let's go for it. Number 15.
Number 15 is
the worst one.
Deservably, Culver's. I did not expect this, guys.
I don't think it was the worst.
It was 100% the worst. So
100%. Why is this one so bad? It's Culver's. Culver's is kind of like a knockoff of Jack in the Box.
So in my personal list, it actually tied for last with a different one. But if I had to really pick this one, it would have been the worst. Honestly, just because I had a higher opinion of Culver's, and I don't know why. Apparently, it didn't deserve it. I haven't had it enough.
Because this was our number 12.
Here's
second to last in tenders.
Listen, the only thing I've had from Culver's is really the
cheese curds.
They're
pretty good. The ice cream. The custard.
The custard.
That's good.
Exactly. I'm like, custard.
That's why you
should go there. Custard means quality. Okay. chicken sandwich. Oh, chicken sandwich. It's like, how would you like dirt in a bun? We fried it. Don't worry.
They're not sponsored.
Breading
on.
Is
okay.
Custard one of the five C's? Of quality?
For sure.
Okay,
yeah,
good.
For sure.
But you're right. This is thin chicken that just is, it feels reheated. It tastes reheated.
It does.
Everything about
it. No, it's genuinely awful.
Yeah.
I thought it would at least be like, oh, yeah, okay, that'll be, I've had some of the butter
burgers. No, Culver's, and just to give you a little, this one comes with no sauce. This is just tomatoes, shredded lettuce, and pickles.
It's actually like they don't like us, and they don't want us to like the sandwich.
The pickles weren't bad. They brought up the
taste. No one that made that sandwich?
The pickles did.
Oh, pickles were fine.
Yeah. No one has actually eaten that sandwich that made it.
So when we ordered it, they're like, what?
No.
I mean, the makers at Culver's, they never ate it. They're like, put chicken in there. I don't know.
But here's the thing. There's no sauce on this one, and there should have been something. Because this cannot stand on its own. The chicken was like flat. The chicken patty was like flat and burnt.
Their website says it's seasoned with onion, garlic, and a pinch of cayenne. Do you believe that?
No.
At all?
I don't believe
this tasted like a school lunch sandwich.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I did not like it. By the way, Culver's founded in 1984 in Wisconsin, just so you know.
Oh, good to know.
The cheese curds.
Cheese curds are good. This one costs $5.09, at least where we were. This The price will vary depending where you go.
Which
sometimes
actually makes it even more offensive.
This is a more pricey one.
I would 100% would have gotten
an ice cream.
No. Carl's Jr. Spicy Chicken Sandwich, which is like a buck something, right?
Yeah.
Which is
That's not part of this challenge.
This one, but Jacob, it does have one of the lower calories, only 460 calories.
Oh, well.
Yeah, so spend it on that more calories, please.
I actually ended up adding, I had some buffalo sauce from Burger King, like a packet of that.
Oh, so you try it and you're like, I need taste on this.
You're like, I got to do something. Halfway through, I'm like, I got to do something to save this. So
do not go to Culver's and get the chicken sandwich.
It wasn't my lowest, but it was definitely down there.
Our number 14 is, why is this on the list? Is this still a fast food chain? Nobody knows, but Arctic Circle.
Wait,
what are you talking about?
Fast food chain? Arctic Circle.
Dude, they have a bazillion locations
here. No, they have the fewest locations of anyone on here.
I feel like I see them all the time.
Arctic Circle was really popular in 1987.
There's 60,
just because they had the saddle seats inside.
No, I tell you why they're popular is the ice cream's actually good.
Once again, the ice cream is the highlight.
There. This has the fewest
locations.
And the free
cones.
62 locations, 50% of which are located in Utah. So
of course.
A local one. Their crispy chicken breast sandwich is $4.89, 632 calories. And I don't know, just this one seemed a little small to me.
So this was my least favorite of all the sandwiches.
Yes, this was
because
your
when I ate it, it was like, you know, when you play air hockey, the pucks, the floaters, it's that size.
Yeah.
That was the chicken. And then they kind of 3D printed breading onto the outside.
Well,
it wasn't even attached to the chicken. It was separated, which was super weird and not tasty whatsoever.
Well, and this one came in a box, and I just maybe because the box.
Presentation is a big deal, by the way.
I mean,
Arctic Circle never wins a presentation. They're the worst at presentation. In fact, they think what could look bad, and then they make that box.
Well, and this one had mayonnaise. This one has mayonnaise and pickles on it, but mine was actually two pieces of chicken.
What?
Oh, it was. Like it was like two tenders or something.
I think
two
you
small
got
pieces.
Some leftovers.
Are you sure you weren't
your
raising
sandwich?
Canes? Okay, yeah. So my expectations were rock bottom. For this, and it was okay.
Well, see, and I getting
it
this
wasn't
one,
good. It was very medium.
You guys remember maybe that I did enjoy the chicken rings,
chicken stars.
The chicken, no, that's it. Carl's Jr. stars.
Oh,
this is the rings,
chicken rings.
I would much rather get the chicken rings than this sandwich again.
Well, that's trouble because the rings are awful,
but they're better than this chicken, and they're cheaper.
I bet they're cooked in the same thing. This is cooked in cottonseed sunflower oil, which is unique. The Arctic Circle, but yeah, it is no good.
Yeah.
And the bun was small, I felt as well. Like, it was very small. Wasn't quite filling.
No, the bun, it was not filling. The bun is small.
You're paying almost $5 for the whole thing, small. Too. It doesn't feel like a $5 sandwich.
No, that is definitely overpriced, yeah. For sure.
But the ice cream's good.
Ice cream is good.
So we should do an ice cream show then.
Listener.
Ooh.
Listener.
Shake show.
Go to Arctic Circle, Butterfinger Hot Fudge. You're going to thank me later.
Yummy.
It is seriously an amazing
combination. I always get hungry when we do these shows.
I know. For something else.
All right, what's next?
Coming up next, we have Dairy Queen, founded in 1940 in Illinois. 6,800 locations. Their crispy chicken sandwich is $3.99.
That's more appropriate.
It's one of the more cheaper ones here, and 550 calories.
What is the deal with good ice cream places having bad food?
It's because
they're about ice cream.
Yeah, they're about ice cream. And this is like, and I've said this before on the show, mm-hmm. Dairy Queen, hey, you go there for a blizzard. You don't go there for anything else.
No, the fries. The fries are good at Dairy Queen.
The fries are good because they're chips. Mm-hmm.
Actually,
a little bit thicker.
Again, rock bottom expectations, and I wasn't offended by eating it. I thought it was all going to be worse than Culver's, and it was like, you know what? I'm not mad right now.
I hate Dairy Queen lettuce. Like, I have rage against Dairy Queen
lettuce.
This
is your second to last, Kent.
That's actually very fair.
I guess it's not even like the crunchy part of the lettuce. It's the really soft outer parts that you peel off.
I think they do this on purpose because they're like, we're about ice cream. If you want lettuce, it's going to suck.
So like, what are you doing? Get a blizzard.
Exactly. Get a blizzard. Are you sure you want this?
This one does have lettuce, tomato, and mayonnaise on it.
Which, it's a classic chicken sandwich, but it's not the
they're not trying
Southern
to do
style.
The fancy hand-breaded flavor. Yeah.
Right.
There's the bread, the chicken's flat. The bread was kind of flat, too.
This one is really crunchy, like the breading.
Well, yeah.
You get really low marks for that.
You don't like breading, crispy breading?
I like it if it's crispy, but it's the perfect consistency. Okay. Perfect consistency is really hard to define. But this one was overly crunchy there was less chicken than there was breading.
So mine was actually perfect on the breading. In fact, it got a better score. I forget what it was exactly for the breading because they toasted it. And no one else had done that.
Toasted the buns?
Yeah, the buns were toasted. And it worked. Honestly,
Culver's
it was nice.
Does that. They toasted their buns.
Did they?
Yeah.
I think they just burnt mine.
Well, my buns burnt.
My buns are a little toasty right now.
Hey, stop it.
It is warm in here.
This one, by the speaking of hot, this one must have come. I had a weird experience where I was in line.
With Kent?
Yeah, no. I was in line for Dairy Queen. And I order, and the car in front of, like, so I've already ordered. I'm waiting to go in the window to pick up my order. And the car in front of me just starts backing up, like, kind of quickly towards me. And I'm like, whoa, okay. Like, I put my car into reverse. Like, do I need to move? And then they drove off. And I'm like, well, that was weird. And then I pull up, and she's like, it's 17 something something. And I'm like, for a chicken sandwich? I just had the one. She's like, oh, did someone leave?
Oh.
And I went,
yeah.
Yeah. That was weird.
Joel, that was me.
Oh, yeah, it was you?
Personal story. There's a Dairy Queen in my neck of the woods here in Davis County, Utah. And it's been there for 40, 45 years. And it's kind of like the go-to spot in Centerville.
Oh.
And it's been there forever. And they're closing it down. They're actually selling the location.
That thing was always busy.
It's the busiest fast food you can get.
But they're closing it down?
Yeah.
Why?
For some reason, they're selling it. I don't know why.
That's weird.
And it's a staple.
That thing is a staple. It's always
the slowest lines in a drive-thru.
That's probably why.
Maybe.
Well, so the person in front of me just drove off, which was weird. But then I get up there, so they have to make my food right then. And my piece of chicken must have come directly out of the fryer. Because I took a bite, and it burned my tongue. The chicken was so hot, it burned my tongue. The bun was kind of lukewarm, like kind of cold almost.
Right.
But the chicken was burning hot.
It wasn't toasted?
I don't remember. My mouth was bleeding at that point.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, that makes sense.
I can't taste.
No, this was one where there's just flakes of lettuce. It wasn't real lettuce. The mayonnaise didn't really add anything. And the tomatoes actually tasted a little off.
Yeah.
And so I was not.
No, their vegetables are really bad there.
I was not pleased with this one.
Again, ice cream.
Right.
They want you to buy the ice cream.
They're royalty for the dairy, but not for the veggies.
Yeah,
this one belongs in a food court.
All right, next up is Sonic.
Sonic.
I personally had Dairy Queen up a notch from Sonic's. Although, I mean, we're getting into the middle range now. Almost.
I was surprised by this one. I had rock bottom expectations with this one because this was our...
How was your ordering experience at Sonic?
Well, here's the thing. Sonic was last place in our nuggets and last place in tenders. When I actually said, oh, we got to do Sonic, I was not looking forward to it. I was going to pull up to one of the kiosks there and have the roller people come out to me, but instead I just went to the drive-thru. Normal drive-thru experience.
Really?
Yeah.
It was not really slow or anything like that?
No, it was oddly efficient.
No, that's crazy.
Or did someone try to sell you drugs while you were there?
Yes, but that's part of what that was normal.
Yeah, I think it's a Sonic experience, right?
No. Yeah. Honestly, Kent, you're right as far as like the stereotype, especially the one by you, because that one always sucked.
Yes. Really long lines.
Yes. A long line on 13th slow. South they too, always mess up. So oh, really my gosh. Scared. Why were you thinking?
Well,
no, that one is famous for being awful. Awful. I have waited 45 minutes in that line before.
There was like a gate on the drive-through window when they opened it. The one on 13th South.
13th South? Oh, dude, that one is seriously scary.
Most things on 13th South are.
There was a syringe in my sandwich, so we got low marks for that.
That's the kid's meal. It's a toy.
Welcome to 13th South. I went through, same experience, Joel. I just want to validate that. I was like, okay, here we go. Get into a Sonic drive-thru line because I'm used to that one. And it was just like perfect and wonderful. And everyone was nice. And my food came fast. It was pretty good. I was like, this isn't bad. It's not, it doesn't compare to some of the higher ups. This isn't bad.
And I had this very much middle of the road for me because I thought, I mean, this has lettuce, tomato, and mayonnaise. It was $4.99. Which isn't great, but but at the same time, this tasted like kind of those premium chicken sandwiches. The chicken was much juicier than I anticipated. Not a lot of flavor, but the chicken was juicy.
And the chicken and the breading matched pretty well. Because
the dry chicken drives me nuts on those sandwiches when they
so many of these are dry.
Yeah. So I was
really even mentioned that.
That's a couple bites in, it was kind of tearing apart like a processed patty a little bit, and I got really like, oh, sure you did, Sonic. Like, you gave me processed meat. So I pulled it apart, and you could see the threading of the chicken there. And I'm like, it's real chicken.
Yep.
I'm so proud of you guys right now.
And the bun I thought was flat, but it had a good flavor, like a buttery flavor to it that I enjoyed.
It did. You know what is even better than that, though, is when you do the Texas toast.
Oh, instead of the buns?
Mm-hmm.
You can get Texas toast.
You've been to Sonic enough where you know.
I actually know Sonic very well.
Why?
Yeah, I the drinks are good. Also,
they're closing down like crazy.
No. They are. Super Sonic cheeseburger with hickory sauce was like the thing as a teenager I really liked so much. Good. And it is actually one of the best when it's done right. And you get bacon on it too. It's one of the best fast food burgers when it's done right.
I don't think I've ever had more apathetic employees at a fast food place.
I agree.
I mean, it used to be you drive up there and it was kind of cool. They'd roll out, roller skate out to you.
Yeah.
Now it's like you pull up to the drive through thing and they're like looking through your window, like, no, just come in.
Yeah.
Just come in.
They're like, we don't even have an inside.
We don't have roller skates anymore. but Sonic does have over 3,000 locations, 3,525.
Still.
Today. I mean, tomorrow it could be down to 2,000.
Sure.
They're closing like crazy. But yeah, I like this one probably more than you guys did, but it's still, this is middle of the road. This is not a good, great chicken sandwich.
It ranks 12 out of 15 for the three of us altogether.
I would have it up a little higher. Well, no, I don't know.
You would say.
The middle's rough.
I feel like it's fair, maybe one
Kent,
step
Kent
above.
Kent definitely like this less than Jacob or I.
Like, think about the other chicken sandwiches we're about to name. Even though they still rank kind of low, I would get those above Sonic any day.
I was actually really disappointed in a couple of these.
Yeah, oh yeah, for sure.
The ones that are ranked above as far as the average goes. But, okay, what's next?
All right, our next one is my favorite place on the planet. I'm thinking Arby's.
It's the toenails, isn't it?
Founded in 1964 in Ohio, 3,472 locations. The classic crispy chicken sandwich costs $4.69 and has 510 calories.
This one really disappointed me.
Me too.
I'm like,
wait,
Arby's, what are you doing?
Did you expect greatness from this one?
I expected a B+.
Have you tried the roast beef?
No, I think it's, I've tried their chicken before, like in the sliders and stuff like that. And other,
and that's usually not bad. Yeah. Tenders.
I was expecting more. Jacob, you and I are on par here because this is the most disappointing award goes to Arby's for me. Cause I went there and I was like, ooh, it was processed. Like it had a really processed flavor to it.
It tasted like a school lunch chicken sandwich to me. Like a really, like it was just put in the microwave and then served to you.
I ate Arby's, Wendy's, Culver's at the same time. For one of them. It was one of the biggest ones.
Wow.
And
bad day.
I won't want like Arby's. I was just like, that was actually, for me, it was the best of those three actually. And it was still bad.
Yeah.
This one did have the most salty taste. Like I felt like it was just white meat with sodium, whereas some of the chicken was just tasteless.
My note here says not much flavor, but it's not a great flavor.
Wait, not much, but it's not there.
Yeah.
No. White meat with white meat, breading, salt. There you go.
Oh, precisely. Very salty.
Yeah.
And this one does have mayonnaise, shredded lettuce, and tomato, but it all just kind of blended together. It was not good. This was not a good experience.
But it does have the brioche bun, which is fine.
Bun is fine. Bun was a ranked category that we had.
Yeah. Arby's actually makes some good things in there. I like a lot.
I cannot wait for our Eat Everything at Arby's show.
Season 11?
Next season.
No.
The Reuben. I like the Reuben. The Reuben's good.
Yeah, I'm a classic roast beef guy. Big fan.
No.
Arby sauce.
So stop it. Oh, stop it. And their cheese is the worst.
Their cheese? There's different cheeses.
The cheese that they put on the roast nacho beef cheese. Now? Yeah, nacho cheese. It's not my cheese.
And coming in at our top 10, number 10, Shake Shack? Founded in 2004.
You sound surprised. You thought it was going to be higher?
This was my lowest ranked one.
Was it?
The lowest? This doesn't even...
Oh, can I jump into the mind of Joel real quick?
This is fast casual. It shouldn't even be on this list.
Probably not. This sandwich is $6. and 99 cents.
This is the priciest and it's the highest cost a la carte.
The size of a slider.
This is why he's mad.
This is the highest cost a la carte. There's another one on here that you have to buy in a combo, and it makes it more expensive. Yeah. Shake Shack only has 250 locations. It started in New York, and the Chicken Shack costs $6.99 and it has 550 calories.
What do they put as a topping there? Is it like an aioli?
No, it's a buttermilk herb mayo. So that's what you get.
So aioli, basically, right?
Yeah. It has lettuce and some pickles on it. But I must have got a bad one. I must have, because this had like a really bitter taste to it, like it was oily and bitter.
The chicken did, or the dressing?
The chicken. Huh. And, well, okay, the chicken was really oily, but there was a bitter taste, and I couldn't figure out what it was coming from. And so this was one of the few ones where I didn't really want to finish it. And I say here, the bun is teeny tiny, but it looks fresh. And then the chicken looks a little scary, to be honest. And it was so expensive. And I was disappointed.
Mine was a little overcooked. I'd never been to Shake Shack before. This was the first time. And I actually heard like positive things. It was like, oh, yeah, that place is great.
Super average.
And yeah, it was super
average. Did you get a shake too? Because
no.
I feel like you have to.
No.
The shakes are like $5.50 and they're like super basic. Like In-N-Out shake.
I did have a sip of one.
Yeah.
And I had fries though. I thought the fries were good. But
One you actually added to the menu too. You said we should include Shake Shack in there.
Well, yeah, that it was my mistake because it shouldn't be.
I ranked this one higher for the chicken quality that I had, because even though it was kind of like a Hawaiian roll, it seemed like, which I like the taste, the chicken was really thick and the breading matched it really well. And granted, I finished this thing and I was like, well, I need another, but I'm not going to spend another $6.99.
No, this is way too expensive for what you get. That's why I ranked. I mean, cost did come into play, but at the same time, it really was. It was the bitterness where I was like, what is wrong with this chicken sandwich?
If you went back to Shake Shack, if you ever would you get something else?
Definitely.
I had a sauce. It was a habanero sweet something something.
Sounds good already.
And someone got it with their fries and they were like, yeah, try a bite of that. I'm literally at a table with a group and I'm like, okay. And I put my fries in it. I put it in my mouth and I said, excuse me. And I stood up and walked back inside to go get my own.
I thought you would walk to the bathroom.
I mean, just like that fast.
Excuse me.
I was like, no, it was I was actually sweating a little bit from that sauce. It was very, very good.
Yeah, this was my lowest rated one. I didn't. And that was one where it surprised me. I kind of put it the scores in. And then at the end, I went, oh, that's my lowest. But it's just how it shook out. You guys seemed like this was much more Jacob.
It was very
Kent,
average.
This made upper tier. And Jacob, this was in like your top four.
The reason this chicken tastes a little different.
I moved it.
And Joel, I don't know you got a really bad one, but this is cooked sous vide style before frying.
Ooh,
which is kind of nice.
Fancy. Oh, really?
Yeah.
They cook it in the water for a long period of time and then sear it.
Well, and then they prepare it with buttermilk and cook it in soy oil. So honestly, it's not the best tasting thing, but
the breading was crispy, crispy, but then it was so oily.
Mine was oily and it was a little overcooked.
For $3.50, I'd be super pleased with this sandwich.
I would have been like, oh, that's a good deal.
Right.
Yeah. No.
But it's not a $7 sandwich. That's almost the price of two chicken sandwiches on any other menu.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. And the chicken had kind of an herby taste to it, like I was trying to be fancy.
Yeah.
What are you trying to do, Shake Shack? You're not fancy chicken. It's fried chicken.
You're mad.
I am mad.
You're so mad.
Not going back there.
It's only number 10, though.
I've only been to Shake Shack twice in my life, and both times I've been like, that was way too much for not that good.
Okay. Understandable.
But you could play cornhole in the back, you know? So
Is that a thing?
And ping pong.
What?
Yeah, the one in Sandy has that.
Really?
Huh.
I thought you were just making stuff up. Is this a dream?
No, this is true.
Welcome back to the show, Jake.
And then I walked to the back room.
And playing cornhole. It was someone's backyard. I don't know.
And they didn't mind. I still won. All right, next up is Burger King.
Cha-king.
This is the best named sandwich,
No,
though.
This is cha-king. The worst named sandwich.
Yes.
You're at the drive-thru. No.
Jacob and
you're like,
I are in
I would
sync
like
tonight.
A cha-king chicken guys, sandwich. Guys. And I'm like, I feel like an idiot.
You don't at all, because everything else is like this kind of Whopper, that kind of Whopper. I'm happy they didn't call us the chicken Whopper. They were like, what's our name? King?
I can't believe they did.
Chicken
do it.
Sounds like king.
Cha-king.
The dad in me loves cha-king.
Okay, cha-king. So, I mean, we did talk all the
it's
stuff
very
about Burger King,
though,
on episode 170. We ate everything at Burger King back in August 2018. This cost $3.99.
Great price.
800 calories. The highest number of calories.
The calories are serious.
Did you guys get sauce on yours?
Yes.
Yes.
I didn't.
No. I got sauce.
They didn't put sauce, just pickles.
I got sauce on half of mine and half was on the wrapper and then like kind of on top.
It's Burger King.
This comes
This
comes what they call savory sauce and deli style pickles, which translates to a sour sauce and sweet pickles.
So the sauce ruined it for you.
This killed it for me.
Listen, I'll tell you guys exactly what I did. I'm on the same page with you, Joel.
What is happening? I
took off the bun.
How do we agree so much, Jacob?
I took off the toppings and I ate the chicken.
Yeah.
Because I had a couple bites and I was like, everything else is awful, but the chicken's pretty good.
No, that's the thing is the chicken breast, this is a big chicken breast. The breading wasn't as crispy as I expected, but it was flavorful.
See, I didn't get a very thick chicken breast because you see the advertising.
Oh, you didn't?
And it's huge.
But mine,
and it's actually like big. Pouring out of the bun. And mine I'm like, oh, that would be awesome. Mine was basic. Mine looks super standard. So
no, I'm sure this sort of thing is this is very, you know,
relative.
This one actually got a lot of high scores for me. Like I liked the bun. I liked the chicken. I liked the breading. And then it got to the toppings and I honestly tanked it because I was like, no, that killed it.
I didn't like the bun or the toppings.
Ugh. If I get this one again, it would
just
be
just the chicken.
Yeah.
Do you guys normally get, because with every one of the, well, most of these places, they have a standard, like a traditional chicken sandwich and a spicy. Do you guys have a preference?
I usually go spicy.
Yeah, I do
same.
Too.
Right, because you want a little bit extra taste and you may not want extra sauce.
For this one,
you need sauce.
I got classics. There's a lot of these ones where I had it twice over because I'd had one like a month or two ago.
Sure.
And so I was like, okay, let me get the other one now. You know? And so, this is the only time I'd ever get classic. Usually it's spicy.
Yeah.
But this is one where reabuyability also I put it like at a one.
It's just a bad experience.
It's fun to order the chicken.
And with a stupid labor shortage, it's like you go to Burger King or some of these places, and there's like an infant that's running around back there and
playing cornhole. And they just throw a packaged burger chicken sandwich out the window. And you
like,
have to
not
catch
even
it.
Kidding. It's like they're going to some serious lengths to get human beings in there to hand you stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just feel like this one would have been better if they wouldn't try to do something fancy. If they'd just gone straight chicken sandwich, it probably would have been better.
What's fancy about it?
There's nothing fancy.
No, I mean the savory sauce. And deli style pickles. Regular pickles on there. Put some mayonnaise on there.
Don't ask Burger King to go extra because they will.
Yeah, drunk cowboys.
All right, number eight. Guys, we have a brand new, at least here in the state, and I think one of the newer franchises of this list. We've got Raising Cane's.
Why?
Because
it fits perfectly.
Why?
Joel.
Why
it's
does
brand
this one,
new. Joel.
No, listen to me. Why did... Are there 4-hour waits for this place?
I went. There was 2 miles of cars.
Joel.
I did too.
It's new.
So can I...
It's new.
People are out of their minds. They're like, oh, food? Something new and cool to do? So we need something to do.
Let me back it up here.
Kids, get in the van.
So Raising Cane's started in 1996 in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. There are 570 locations. The sandwich combo is what we had to get because you can't just get a la carte sandwich. You have to get the sandwich combo.
That's right.
Comes with fries and a drink. Costs $7.79, 780 calories.
Sandwich combo or chicken tender sandwich?
Yeah,
because that's what it is.
It's
like 3 pieces of chicken tenders.
They just throw 3 tenders on a sandwich and call it good. This comes with cane sauce and a soggy piece of lettuce.
How do you feel about the cane sauce?
Delicious.
I like the sauce.
I actually have made homemade cane sauce. I found
it too peppery, honestly.
Chicken's middle for me. Sauce I liked.
So the chicken is nothing without the sauce.
It's so true.
But
it's so true.
I actually found a recipe, and it's basically fry sauce with Worcestershire sauce.
Hold on, Worcestershire sauce, please.
It's mayonnaise. It's mayonnaise, ketchup, Worcestershire sauce, garlic powder, salt, and freshly ground black pepper. That's what cane sauce is. So I made that at home, and I put it on a couple things.
So this could be like a classic, because this is like a Southern style chicken place, right? That's my Southern style voice
right there.
But the bun ruins the entire sandwich for me.
The bun?
Yeah, the bun was so... Okay, it wasn't awful, but it was a standard bun. Oh, yeah, I didn't get the toast.
It was very standard.
It wasn't like even a brioche bun. Like, you could copy Chick-fil-A. You could copy Popeyes. Mm-hmm. Honestly, they should have copied Popeyes. My initial note on this was, why does this place exist when we have Popeyes?
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't make sense.
Can I just tell you my brief experience with ordering?
It's a good point.
So just ordering there. So I had the apps on a lot of these, so I could order ahead and just go pick it up and go away there.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew Raising Cane's. I'd heard stories about how long the lines were. So I was like, okay, I'll just use the app. So I, first of all,
that's not going to help you.
I checked the price a day before I actually went there. And then on the day I went to go get there,
You get there? That's like an hour drive for you.
We were at IKEA.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, yes.
It was a bad day.
It was a bad day.
So you're in hell and you thought, I know what I need.
I need to go wait in line at Raising Cane's.
Was this the same day Jake had his 3 worst chicken sandwich experiences?
He got to meet the devil and Cane in the same day.
So,
well played.
But anyway, so I go the day of. I'm there. I'm like, okay. I went to go do it. And it's like, you still have an order in your cart or whatever.
Hmm.
And I'm like, fine, delete it. And it wouldn't let me delete it for the longest time. I finally had to clear it all out. And I tried to update my time to like, no, I want it today. And it's like, no, you have to clear out your cart before you do this. I'm like, just change the date. And it's like, no. Then after I deleted everything and I said, okay, I'm going to make my order. And I said, make it for ASAP. And the button grayed out. And I clicked ASAP again. And the button
grayed
out.
Like you're buying a PlayStation 5? What's going on here?
I'm like, you're telling me you can't make it as soon as possible?
Yeah, because that doesn't mean right now.
By definition, it just means as soon. You could tell me it's not going to be ready for however long.
4 to 6 weeks.
So I said, fine. I'll bump the order ahead 20 minutes. And they said, no, can't do that. So I said, fine. So I drive down there, and I drive up to the Raising Cane's.
How long?
Did you have, did all of a sudden your hair grow out, like an A-frame haircut?
So I drive up, and I'm like, man, that parking lot is really, really full. That wasn't the parking lot. That was the line of cars going into the street.
Wow.
And I went, oh, you got to be kidding me. So I said, I'll just park in the parking lot and walk in.
What time of day was this? Did you go down the... Oh, you parked. Okay.
So I went to go park.
What time of day?
This is probably, I don't know, 6.
Oh, okay. Dinner time.
Yeah, around then.
Right.
So
there's no good time, honestly.
I go.
Except maybe in the morning.
And I go to park at in the parking lot of the Raising Cane's and just walk in because I didn't want to use the drive-thru. It's full. So I'm like, I'll go next door. Next door is a Warren's. And the parking lot is completely empty.
It's so sad, isn't
And there's
it?
A sign that
All
says...
the employees are looking out the window with
the sign says,
eyes.
Warren's parking only, violators will be towed, and there's no one in the parking lot. And Raising Cane's is full. So I had to go to the 7-Eleven next to that, park there, and then walk across the crosswalk.
I did almost the exact same thing. That's really funny.
It was ridiculous.
Yeah.
So I walk in, there's one person ahead of me. Yeah. And I'm like, cool.
Great.
And the restaurant is packed.
Oh, wow.
And so I go up, I order my food.
You must have came later because
And then I realize there's no one in line, but I look around the restaurant, no one has food. Everyone had ordered and sat down and waited.
You're the 50th person in line.
I had to wait a half hour to get my order of a chicken sandwich combo. It was ridiculous. Anyway, I've ranted a little bit. That did definitely affect my ranking. This is my second to last.
I learned from you and everyone else that went during prime time hours. I went at 3 p.m. to this one. It was a 45-minute drive to go get the sandwich.
Yeah.
And there was a 15-minute wait. And that is it. So they do have the two lanes, kind of like Chick-fil-A often does, or sometimes McDonald's. Only a 15-minute, but honestly, 15 minutes at 3 p.m. when no one else should be eating? That's so weird.
Well, yeah, but that means you got into it at a better time.
Yeah, truly, truly.
Well, and the most disappointing thing, I was actually talking to it. I got to know some people while we're waiting for our food. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, is it worth the wait? And the guy's like, oh, yeah. Oh, it's totally worth the wait. I'm like, oh, good. I've been looking forward to a good chicken sandwich.
Utah, the land of no taste.
Okay.
Right?
Speaking of no taste. No taste. The chicken had no taste. It tasted like I thought it was quality chicken. Like it tastes like it was good chicken.
Yes,
no
I agree.
Flavor whatsoever. And then I dipped in the cane or I had the cane sauce. I got a bite with cane sauce on the sandwich, and I went, "Well, that was good. I like that." But then I get to a part without cane sauce, and I'm like, "This is just moist fluff."
Did you get the toast? Everyone says the toast is great. I'm like, "It's toast.
It is good though."
Yeah, it doesn't save Raising Cane's.
Well, I mean, I'm kind of with you. It's not that it was overhyped. I honestly didn't even have crazy expectations. It was just like, okay. And then I had it and I'm like, why are we all you people sitting in line?
Yeah.
Like at the time I had it was tenders first. Well, of course it was all tenders. And I just thought, I prefer Carl's Jr. To this.
And the breading tasted kind of like oily and it wasn't that crispy. It was kind of a soggy.
I did like the sauce though.
The sauce was good. The crinkle fries, not that we're doing fries, but the fries were bland.
You mean elementary school fries?
Yeah.
Crinkle fries?
Okay.
Why do people do that? We're all adults now.
I picture playing that crab soccer on those little butt scooters and you get those fries stuck in your hands as you're playing.
No, the fries were bland. The chicken was bland. And then the bun was the type of bun you get from a grocery store.
Yeah.
There was nothing special was really about this place except for the sauce.
Yeah, I didn't get enough sauce then.
That was very special, the line.
Yeah, that was.
Well, we've talked about Raising Cane's
a long time. Well, it's because it's gotten like
unique.
Headlines.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they just opened a new one. It's going to be more, but this was so overrated. And I don't like that it made this high up on our list.
I'm with you. I didn't want to
eat
number
it
eight.
Sauce.
So number still, 8 is too high.
Okay, it might be too high.
Well, that's because there's worse ones. That's all.
Maybe when the hype dies down, I'll try it
bad.
Again.
It was just...
But if I can get the cane sauce, I'll be fine with just that. In fact, I make it
just
at home
cane
now.
Sauce.
Well,
yeah.
That's what makes up for it. That's what keeps it at number 8, Joel.
And at number 7, we have Wendy's.
Now, this is way too high. This is really... This is wrong. This is absolutely wrong.
Are you still
wrong.
Mad about no. last year? What's Kent going on?
This is the only one that made me angry.
About
this
the ranking?
Like so low for you. This is one of your worst ones.
Yes, I could not believe it tied for the bottom.
Now, we did already talk about Wendy's at length on We Ate Everything at Wendy's back in July 2020.
The spicy chicken sandwich is one of my favorite things at Wendy's.
I like Wendy's. I had a classic for this.
Yeah.
Kent, it was awful.
What happened?
I don't know. I don't know. But I ate it and I was genuinely mad at Wendy's. I was like, Wendy's, what have you done? What have you done? And I cried and
cried.
Yeah, I fell on the floor. People had to pick me up and they're like, it's just a sandwich, Jacob. And I'm like, yeah.
They knew your name. So,
I've got a lettuce issue. I've already talked about Dairy Queen's lettuce being like the soft outer parts of the lettuce head.
This is the slab of iceberg.
This is the iceberg chunk, right? Yeah. That hurts your teeth when you bite into it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Every time. Where do they get all these chunks? Slather the mayo on there. That is my real problem.
Oh, yeah. Mayo. Oh, man, Kent, I have.
There was tons of mayo.
I said a slab of iceberg lettuce isn't great. Maybe too much mayo?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a lot.
But I did say, that by this one is 490 calories. And
I must have tomatoes, lettuce,
pickles,
bad one.
Tomatoes, lettuce, pickles, and mayonnaise, which is that's kind of the full Monty of what's going on with the sandwich. And I said, this one tastes like I expect the chicken sandwich to taste.
See, this one,
nothing
for
special,
me was,
nothing bad. Just
it's juicy, but it's thin. I mean, it's small, right? It's not, it doesn't go out of the bun, right? Mm. It's very contained, but it did have a good taste. I thought the breading was quite good as well.
But the problem is having
Doesn't Wendy's have a special hand-breaded one? That's really
this
the question.
Kind of what
I think
why,
they don't want to mess with their original recipe.
Well, their original recipe sucks.
Jacob, explain to me hand breading. Like, because I get the marketing behind it, but I'm just like, just why do I want someone's hands on my chicken?
Well, Chick-fil-A does it. They say they do it.
Yeah, that's
true. They pressure cook it.
Yeah, yeah.
But
with their hands.
Every time I see, Carl's Jr. does the word like hand breaded, and my mind goes, ooh, that sounds good. And then I go, wait.
Someone's touching it?
Yeah, someone's dipping it in egg and then flour.
Joel,
and
think about the human beings that are touching all that food before it comes out the window.
But are you saying that the other ones are not hand-breaded? That, like,
no.
It's a machine?
No, they are definitely machines.
Robots are doing it?
Robots have done this.
Yeah, it's robots.
And that means consistency.
Consistency, actually, which also means less opportunity for something great.
But yeah, I want the TLC. I want someone's hands on my chicken patty, right?
Yeah, you want it really
massaging
on there.
It in there.
Well, and the breading's always better, right? It's thicker. Yeah. It means that it just means it's better.
Little stamp of goodness right there.
Yeah, yeah.
With a thumb.
It means someone cared about the breading as well.
The problem is, I think that all of us having eaten everything at Wendy's, we know there's better options out there. Like you can get jalapenos and barbecue sauce on this chicken sandwich, and it will make it better.
Yes, that would have made it better.
And so this just by itself,
I was kicking myself for not being like, why didn't I get something special on
middle
this?
Middle of the road. You were offended by it. For me and Kent, looks like it was middle of the road.
I was offended. I'm still mad.
It's a fine chicken sandwich.
I'm going to write an angry letter to Wendy's.
Oh, we already did last year. It was an hour and a half.
All right. Next up is McDonald's. And for the first time in my life.
Number six.
Number six is McDonald's. And this is the only time in my life where something at McDonald's beat Wendy's. and it did, actually. The sauce on their chicken sandwich was actually butter.
Yeah.
It's butter.
It's butter and crinkle cut pickles.
Okay, that's kind of cool.
That's
kind of cool. You know? And then, it's a potato-based bun, which is cool. And
unique, actually, in this list.
This is actually the cool part. McDonald's, you did something unique.
Did they, though? Because
for the first time in your life.
This is a direct ripoff of, like, a Chick-fil-A.
Well,
Chick-fil-A. This is a wannabe Chick-fil-A sandwich. You get it, you're like, oh, pickles and butter on a bun? Okay.
Does Chick-fil-A do butter?
Yeah.
I never noticed that.
I'm pretty sure.
And they have a tempura batter. On this one, which is also unique to these chicken sandwiches.
It's the chicken nugget batter.
Yeah, the batter is unique. Yeah.
This one, by the way,
it's better
there
than on the nuggets.
It is.
Wins the award for no surprise.
Meat inside.
Most locations.
Oh, right. There's meat inside.
And then also lowest cost. This one only costs $3.90, 470 calories.
They're like, wait, what's the lowest bid? $3.99? $3.90.
Yeah.
I think we're actually getting to the point in the list now where it's like, I would eat this again.
Yeah, I agree.
Actually, before this, I'm like, I really don't care.
But here's where this whole dichotomy for me jumps in, is there's a dollar spicy McChicken sandwich, which is processed meat, but it's
and
a dollar.
And that's the problem.
And there's a $4 good chicken sandwich, but I'm like, it's the same size. What do I do here?
That's the problem. Is the hot and spicy chicken sandwich is only a
you
buck.
Spend the $4.
I would buy that one more.
No, also, like a grown-up man.
No.
You spend the $4 and you eat chicken.
So you can get the crispy chicken sandwich for $3.90.
Or so you have nuggets like a child.
Or you can get the crispy sandwich deluxe, which comes with lettuce and tomato, and it's 60 cents extra for lettuce and tomato.
Oh, that's like a Chick-fil-A scheme right there.
The bun fell apart for me on this one. I wasn't overpressed with that, but that was really the lowest mark for it.
So
I thought it was really
Jake, you said there's butter on this. The butter must have seeped into the breading and the bun because I didn't notice any sauce. I just noticed the two pickles. Mm. Yeah. And so it was fine. Like I was like, there's nothing objectionable about that because Chick-fil-A pulls it off. McDonald's less so, but still surprisingly good.
But still pretty good.
Fun fact, in April 2021, McDonald's franchisees were selling about 262 chicken sandwiches per day.
So each franchisee on average was selling that much.
That's a lot of chicken sandwiches. Whew.
That is a lot.
Yeah. And we actually, when we talked about a bunch of McDonald's things back on episode 84, we ate everything at McDonald's.
Five years ago.
This was one of those offerings that I went, it feels too expensive for McDonald's, but it's like the lowest cost.
Yeah.
But there's a dollar menu. So that's why it was hard for me to do reliability for this.
I was like, this is where I'd eat them again, but I would never go to McDonald's for this chicken sandwich.
Yeah. If you're going to go to this one, you might as well pay a little bit extra to get the Chick-fil-A,
which is a better version of the same thing. Yeah.
Agreed. All right, guys, I need to take a little break during this show.
We talk about CJ's?
We'll talk about some chicken sandwiches coming up. But before we get to our top five chicken sandwiches.
Ooh, oh, what's going to happen?
It's a song.
I prepared a song. I was doing some Kent research.
Only a slightly different variation.
It's very
Cool. It's actually shorter.
Let's hear yours. Let's hear your research noise. Sounds about right.
That's good. But I was doing research, and literally 2 hours before the show, I said, oh, no, it's one of these shows. Oh, no. I usually write a song when we just do one type of food, and Joel writes the songs for the entire menu.
For the menu.
And I said,
I like how there's enough of a pattern where you guys know
it's
that.
Weird. It's like clicks in there.
I forgot about it until you just mentioned it.
I think I feel guilty. And so in a half hour, I wrote a really dumb parody song. So I'm about to perform it now live.
It's really underselling this.
Yeah. Because it's horrible. So
you didn't pre-record this one very quietly in your basement?
No, I might have to after I perform it right now. But I'd like to apologize to everyone with ears. Chicken. 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 It started with Chick-fil-A, but then Popeyes came to play. There were other food chains who wanted part of that dough too. Chicken on a brioche bun. Who will be our number one? We waited so long in line for average Raising Cane's.
Yeah.
Chicken. There we go. One more. Chicken. Arby's, Shake Shack, and Zaxby's. Arctic Circle, KFC, McDonald's, and Burger King, Sonic, Culver's, Dairy Queen, Chicken Pickles, Mayo Bun. We're so full and it's no fun. And I hate myself so much, I want another one. They pair so well together, stuck in our guts forever. I hate it and I want some more chicken. There we go.
One and a half. You have spent a lot of time singing along like Rivers Cuomo.
You mean my entire life?
He really has even the tiny little bits of this stuff.
The insecure falsetto.
Rivers will be proud.
Thank you.
Kent, you nailed the feeling I have where I'm like, oh god, that chicken sandwich is terrible. I could go for a chicken sandwich
right
now.
Honestly. But we're going to get there.
Because today when I had the last one,
were you sad?
I pulled out of the bag. No, I shuddered. I physically did. What have I done? And then I had a bite and I was like, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Today was my first day without a chicken sandwich in a long time. And I craved it because it's been such a pattern.
Oh my gosh.
Like an addict.
I feel sick talking about this.
All right. Thanks, Kent. Thank you for that.
Well, you're welcome.
Let's get into our top five.
So hopefully we can make you hungry at this point of the show, because these are the strangely quality chicken sandwiches.
Yeah.
Yep. These are the good ones.
So our number five, guys, I'm a little bit surprised by this because I like the place, but I didn't like the sandwich, but you guys ranked it very high. It's Carl's Jr. or as I like to call it, CJ's.
Yes. There's the same amount of syllables as Carl's Jr.
No one calls it CJ's.
Carl's Jr.
CJ's.
Same as syllables.
No.
This actually made my, this is in my top five when I ranked it. And then Kent, you ranked it really low.
11.
Which is weird.
I like Carl's Jr.
Kent, I don't know anyone that likes Carl's Jr.
Either
you're
going to end there.
You're right.
Either you're going to end there. I don't know anyone. I mean,
it inspired my dating life. Let's not lie there.
No,
so.
Carl's Jr. Like,
yeah, you named your girlfriend CJ.
But Carl's Jr.
It's weird you call her that.
This is our top
Carl's
three in tenders. Yeah. And then it was our number 10 second to last in nuggets.
No, think about it. You get the presentation of the box, right? There's no aluminum bag there. It's the box that you have to open up. The breading is fine, but the chicken for me, it was like schnitzel. It was really thin. It was a really thin cut on this. And I was disappointed because...
Have you not had this multiple times?
No, I mostly get burgers from Carl's Jr.
What's it called? It's like the...
The toast.
Gold digger. Gold digger.
No.
The sauce.
I'd say she's a gold digger. No.
So I got two. I got two from Carl's Jr. because they had the classic and then they had a different sauce.
What's in that sauce?
I do not know, but it was delicious.
Gold.
Oh, gold. Yeah, gold Carl's sauce. Jr.
Joel's probably already looked up what's in that sauce.
This one just comes with a mayo and pickles. That's what's on the standard.
It's also $6.09.
This is an expensive one. This isn't one I get all the time, but I was pleased with it.
It was good.
I said the breading on this one was a little bit soggy, but it still tasted good. There was a good taste to it. It had a softer texture overall to it.
Yeah.
And I thought the chicken was... hearty enough. So yeah.
And you think it deserves the number five spot?
I think that's fair.
There's nothing I would want higher that's below it.
I'm pretty sure it's hand breaded. So that's important.
Oh, I'm sure from Carl's Jr.
they totally do say that. The hand breaded chicken tenders.
They do. It's hand breaded.
That's totally a thing. This one was nice and hot when I got it. The bun was a little squash, but it was fine. Actually, one of my notes here says, the flavor is bland, but it's a good kind of bland.
That explains it.
No, that's actually, I know what you're saying right now.
I think that's their new commercial pitch.
But it's like, it's very pleasant.
Yes.
Like it's,
it's a good kind of bland.
It's a good kind of
bland. That's funny. It works. It just works. I'm trying to look up what that sauce is and I can't win. It's not there. So it's brand new. It's like a promotional type sauce.
I haven't tried it.
Yeah. No, gold digger sauce. That's good.
So then we go into our number four, which is KFC.
Were you guys shocked by this?
This was the most shocking thing, positive wise. I was like, when I almost had the same experience, right? I'm grabbing that. I'd already had two chicken sandwiches that day or something like that.
And
I'm getting that one and I'm like, oh my gosh. And oh, I'm going to have to do this. I take a bite and I'm like, that's pretty good.
I mean,
I ate the whole thing. It's the only one I ate.
This was above average
besides Popeyes
for both Kent and I. This was above average ranking. But Jacob, this was like your number two.
It was number two.
It definitely has the, you know how KFC chicken has that taste. Like it's a very specific taste. Which is that.
I don't even like that taste usually
because generally there's a little bit more salty, breading. It's a little too crunchy for the chicken.
Yes.
Yeah. But you like it?
The sandwich, it just worked. I don't know if it was on the bun or what it was, but this piece of meat was the largest I had on any sandwich.
This is a thick piece of chicken.
It was crazy.
I appreciated the thickness of the breast.
I couldn't stop. Now what I'm going to say is going to sound even weirder.
Sure.
But I couldn't stop eating that thing because I was just like, okay, I'm not even hungry anymore, but I can't stop. It tastes too good.
Right. But at the same time, this is mayonnaise and one pickle. Bun is pretty standard.
I love how it's one pickle specifically.
Yeah, I was like, one pickle. Come on.
Right.
You can spring for two. It didn't wow me, though. Like, I was like, it was what I expected from KFC. I was like, this is KFC chicken on a bun.
I expected far worse.
I expected so much worse.
I just expected, like, a crunchy breading sandwich.
Don't get me wrong. Yes, it's KFC now on a bun. I didn't think it was the KFC then on a bun.
Right.
I thought it was going to be, like, three-fourths breading, and then there's some chicken in the middle that's pretty good, and the whole thing's just like a grease ball.
Yeah, it's a hearty recommendation. Like, if I went to KFC, I would get this again.
I would 100% get that. I got the little
sandwiches. I think I like those better.
Those are good, too.
And they're cheaper.
Yes.
I was like, instant 9 out of 10 for me.
Really?
Yeah, I just loved it.
And it's $3.99, so
yes, and the price was great too.
Yeah. So that's a good one. Huge surprise.
All right, so next up is in number three spot. We're in the top three now, guys.
Top three.
Top three is Zaxby's.
Wait, what place?
Zaxby's.
Highly, they serve salads.
They do. This is highly sandwiches. Deserved, I feel. Like, Zaxby's was one of the best. I felt it was one of the best tasting ones on there.
But do you ever say, I feel like Zaxby's right now?
Sometimes, yes.
Strangely, no. That has never happened. Never.
The thing is, Zaxby's has a unique flavor that I mentioned this before, but my wife stood in line when One by Us opened, and we got free Zaxby's for a year.
Oh, I remember that.
And so it was every week we got a card.
So you're kind of sponsored by Zaxby's.
Kind of, except for the fact that...
So Zaxby's doesn't have a place in our heart, Kent, and it does for Joel. Now.
Yeah.
It does, because it has
a
unique flavor.
Well, it does now
flavor.
In our heart, because
Zaxby's
it's
has both
heart.
A unique,
stay there forever.
It has a unique chicken flavor and a unique sauce flavor, where it's like, I can tell Zaxby's... If you put a lineup of chicken sandwiches I've been into, I'm like, that's a Zaxby's sandwich. Mm-hmm. Because there is an extra flavor to this one. It isn't just bland chicken. This has a flavor. By the way, they have 910 locations. Their signature sandwich costs $4.99. The calories, 780.
This was the only one I thought the chicken was actually... This is going to sound weird. It was too moist.
Oh.
It was like...
I disagree.
It was wet in the middle.
Oh.
Was that
because of the Zax sauce? This has Zax sauce and pickles on it.
The problem is when you have like the aluminum pouch that they put these in, sometimes it will keep it too moist. If you wait too long to eat it...
The breading was okay. It was inside the chicken. Inside the breading, it was like... There was like... It was like the chicken was sweating in there. Like it was nervous. Yeah, exactly.
See, I had a different experience because I was not looking forward to this day because I got Zaxby's and Culver's like right in a row. And I was about to eat each side by side going, I hate today. And then the Zaxby's one blew me away.
It was really good.
Yeah, moist and tasty.
No, I love this flavor. Good flavor, good sauce.
And the chicken goes outside the roll as well.
Mm-hmm. The chicken was hearty.
It's 100% one I'll have again.
Yes. This is when the bun is toasted. It's just a good combination.
I agree.
And I'm not saying no. I don't go out of my way to go to Zaxby's. But if I was like, hey, where's a good chicken sandwich? I'm like, well, Zaxby's is right there.
But is Zaxby's ever right there?
It's for me. It is.
Zaxby's is 45 minutes away.
Zaxby's just a quick 45 minutes, and you can have.
I don't know if it's a 45 minute drive, but a 20 minute drive, sure.
Sure.
Yeah. Under 20, you're good. So yeah, Zaxby's. I think it's tasty. I enjoy it. I would get it again. And
same.
You can also get this is one where you can get Zax sauce on it, but you could also get a variety of different sauces Zax sauce on if you want. You can get like the nuclear sauce, wherever they have it. Like,
is that really good? I've never tried it.
Did you guys get spicy or classic on
classic?
This? I did classic.
Yeah, we went classic on all these because I think we all would agree the spicy chicken sandwich is one of one over any regular chicken sandwich.
Save it for the spicy chicken sandwich show.
Let's do that next week.
Oh.
So I feel like we're at the part of the show where really this is like the Miss America pageant where there's two finalists and we're not sure who's going to take the crown.
Well, we're sure, but the listener isn't.
We're sure. The listener needs to know.
They don't know and they're wondering because these are the two top dogs in this, right?
Because I'm annoyed at you two.
Wait just a second.
I'm not saying the results. I'm just saying I'm annoyed at you two because this is not the number two I would have put. I would have put this one at number one.
Well, we know this based on scoring.
Because I put it at number one.
So.
But you guys didn't.
There are two obvious finalists here.
Yep.
Yes.
And the others got a consolation prize. They won for other things. They're nice. They're great. But these two are legends.
Zaxby's was my number two, I think, initially.
Okay.
KFC was my number two.
Drum roll, please.
Yeah, this is the big moment.
Our first runner-up.
Which means not the winner.
Not the winner. For the chicken sandwich challenge.
The first loser.
Baconsale Science.
It's Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich.
Yes. What?
The original.
What?
Dethroned.
Are you kidding me?
No,
you guys?
You're right, Joel. It should have been number three.
No. No, Jacob, you've torpedoed many things we love in the past. But
McDonald's fries, for example.
This one, the Chick-fil-A sandwich to me, by the way, the lowest calories on this one.
No, that wins calories. For me,
well, it's because they don't put any sauce there.
It's the best tasting, healthiest one.
Well, and here's the thing is I always thought of Chick-fil-A, and still kind of do, as like a pricier place. But it's $4.15.
Yeah.
This is basically...
Unless you want the deluxe.
Well, it's also half the amount of chicken that you just got at the KFC one.
No.
Or Zaxby's.
No.
Half the amount of chicken. I agree. Maybe two-thirds the amount of chicken that you're getting. But the chicken is cooked to perfection.
It's so good.
In fact, so I saw a meme. Mm-hmm. And sorry if this may offend anyone. I'm throwing it out there. But the meme said, Chick-fil-A chicken tastes like it was raised by both parents. And I will never be able to forget it because it does. This is healthy. This is a healthy chicken boy.
So
this is delicious.
I'll bring it back to something a little more appropriate here. This had such a familiar taste.
I've got no words.
Like this was nostalgia in a bun. When I ate this, I'm like, that is what I want in a chicken sandwich. And you can also dip it in Chick-fil-A sauce, Kent.
Do you know what I think?
Which is it nostalgia? Good.
I eat a whole chicken sandwich and you know what happens? I don't think about anything. I'm just eating it and then I'm done. I was like, yeah, that was nice.
This is a magic trick. This sandwich is a magic trick because it's like all I am giving you is a bun, a chicken breast, a pickle, and a bun. Nothing else.
Yeah.
And then you eat it and you're like, ta-da!
No, it really is that good.
Like, if I would have got this,
but here's the thing:
it's a rip-off.
Chick-fil-A is kind of a magic trick.
Chick-fil-A is, like as we said last week, my overrated fast food place. Like, I don't think there's really much there, and so I'm like, oh, I never feel like Chick-fil-A, but when I'm there, I do get the spicy chicken sandwich or this one, and I'm always really happy with it because I feel like I'm having a quality sandwich.
Yeah.
And that's what this presents. Nothing super memorable, like you're saying, Jake, but a really tasty sandwich.
There is actually one memorable part to this.
Okay.
This is kind of a strange word for it, honestly, but you know, you eat some of these things and you're like, how many chemicals did I just eat? How much oil did I just eat? And this is one of the cleanest tasting sandwiches.
And that's the way they cook it, they actually do pressure cook it.
Yes.
It's a unique way they cook these chicken breasts so that it just kind of cooks all the flavor inside of it. Because the breading, is good. The chicken is good. Like, there's a taste to both of them. And mm-hmm. then you could add the Chick-fil-A sauce on top of it, which makes it even better.
In fact, the chicken is dipped in milk and egg wash, which sounds refreshing.
And I've heard that it's marinated in pickle juice as well.
Well, not everyone loves pickles.
But essence of pickle.
Yeah, but it's
tell me more about this egg wash.
Oh, the egg wash.
Will it help my skin?
It actually yes. will.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then it's cooked in peanut oil, which is also unique for these sandwiches.
This was our number one in our nugget show, and it was our number two in our tender show.
And not very well on the fry show.
No. Second to last. The fries here. But I'll tell you what, I will always be up for a chick. If someone's saying, hey, you want to go Chick-fil-A? I'll be like, yeah, sure. Sounds good. And people, I'll usually get the spicy.
How do they do it, though? Just pickles. That's it.
I don't know.
But it's great.
So well cooked.
Do you guys ever have people argue with you about the Chick-fil-A fries?
Yes. Yeah.
And they're like, they're amazing. And I actually take a moment and look at that person and I question anything they've ever said.
As same, you should. Actually. Yeah. Thank you. We're similar.
This is
way.
One. The one downside is this is one where you probably should eat it there because if you leave it in the foil bag too long, the bun gets soggy.
So soggy.
And the breading on this, it's not crispy breading. This is not a crispy batter breading. This is like.
No, it's very thin.
I think it's hand breaded. But
it is hand breaded.
It's hand breaded?
Mm-hmm.
But it's just the kind of it's coating their pleasure. It.
Hand-breaded by a robot.
By the way, I went the other day.
They put a
they
put
did
hands
not say
robots.
My pleasure. I complained to the manager. Yeah. No, he really didn't. But yeah.
They didn't, huh?
No.
So yes, number two.
Number two.
Oh, stop is it. Anytime they hand me something, and I'm like, hey, thanks. And they're like, my pleasure. And I'm like, oh, stop it.
Shut up.
Like, no, it's not, you liar.
Quit smiling.
You hate your job.
So I'm going back to Sonic where they're going to scowl.
They just yell at me there.
That was my number one. And that I.
Well, I get it because it's even if this got number one on the show, well deserved.
Yes. But this next one, I was going to say, this next one, I'll say this. I got Chick-fil-A and this other sandwich on the same day. Like, you know how I was doing two at a time?
Oh, this is a big day.
That was the first day. And I was like, this is going to be the best challenge ever because I loved that's both awesome. Of them.
And it went downhill from there.
And it was.
Yeah, you should start
I started
with
off with the best ones. And so I have no problem with this one being up there. I'm just a little mad that it beat the OG.
Yeah.
And I don't like that because I don't agree with it. But you too.
The OCS, the original chicken sandwich.
So I have to say it. Crap. Our number one, according to BaconScience.
Come on, it's great.
No, our number one is Popeyes.
Popeyes.
Woo! Yeah! Yay.
So here's the thing.
Well done, guys.
Every time I go to Popeyes.
I can't argue with it because now it's BaconScience.
It's BaconScience.
It is BaconScience.
Every time I go to Popeyes and I get the chicken sandwich, or I can get this one interchangeably with the spicy chicken to be just as happy.
Me too. They're good.
And I go through the drive-thru, I say, you know what? I bet it's not very good. I bet this time they kind of don't care about cooking it well. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get something super breaded.
Okay, I've
every
had this experience.
Single time I open up, and literally, this is what I said. I open it up, and they have the paper diaper inside the aluminum bag. No, like, they care.
Make it sound good at all.
And then I open it up, I said, in these words, I quote it, oh my gosh, why even try? Because I knew this was going to be the best sandwich. And I bit into that thing, and it was beauteous.
Now, just to make sure, you know what I did, Kent? Hmm. For every other sandwich I had on this list, I had a Popeye sandwich right there.
Stop
with it.
That.
Just every single
no, you
time.
Can't do that. That's unfair.
That would have been good.
That's unfair.
The classic chicken sandwich comes in at $3.99, so 16 cents less than Chick-fil-A.
Yeah. Perfect price, though.
Calorie 699. Yep. This is pushing it up there. Now, here's my problem with it, was that when I got it, and I have got it before, the bun was flat and cold. There's nothing really special about the bun for me, but the chicken was warm. The chicken is good.
Well, did you eat it fresh or did you wait till you got home?
Right as soon as I drove away, I got the chocolate beignets and
those beignets are awesome.
No, they were overrated.
No, they're good.
No,
I was
take
like,
it back.
It was like $1 for like three of them. I'm like, that's such a great price. And they were like,
oh, I spent $2.50 for three of them.
Size.
If they were $15, I would have bought it.
Look, they're not beignets.
Save it for a beignet show.
What other fast food place are you like? You know, could I get
none.
The powdered chocolate
no
beignets?
No other place would have beignets.
Raising Cane's like, we got toast.
Right? They're like, toast? Do you want toast or fries
back
or
to the chicken?
It's like, I like the beignets, please.
So
the beignets
are where it has the advantage, one of the things, both Zaxby's and Popeyes, it's more of a crispy breading, like a batter on it.
So you've talked about this in previous shows, the umami?
Yes.
The mouthfeel
yes,
about it.
Yes.
And they use MSG for that.
But I feel like the reason Popeyes didn't score high as Chick-fil-A is it was more of a salty taste than it didn't have as much character as Chick-fil-A or Zaxby's as I thought.
See, no, here's the thing. It has both. That's why this one works.
It's good. I have no problem
salty,
with the sandwich.
It has that salty, guilty thing, and it's greasy, and then it has this unique flavor, and then you marry them together, and it's like, it's everything Chick-fil-A everything greasy
ready?
Is, and it's all in one.
Popeye's chicken sandwich is made of buttermilk battered white meat on a brioche bun, along with pickles and mayonnaise or spicy Cajun spread.
And cooked in beef tallow.
Oh my gosh, how am I wanting another one of these right now?
Is it cooked in beef tallow?
It is.
That would explain something.
Like, it feels, and granted, this is like started in Louisiana, but it feels like you just flew to Louisiana. And
this was
someone never, hands you this
Aunt
amazing,
so-and-so is like, exact, yeah.
This actually beat out Chick-fil-A back on our tenders show as well. This was our number one on tenders and our number two in nuggets. By
great
the way,
sauces there as well.
Moment of silence for PDQ, which doesn't exist anymore.
PDQ,
it is so sorry.
Please. Also, Church's Chicken that isn't near us. So
yeah, and there was other ones like Jack in the Box. We didn't go to that one because it was too.
And
far away.
Another new chicken tender place that we haven't tried. It's like Charlie's Chicken Tenders or something like that. That
have you been to Slim Chickens?
No,
that's really good actually.
But we went with chains.
Save for our off-brand chicken show.
That's a franchise name.
Joel, I agree with you. The bun here is like almost purposely flat. Like they kind of sat on it. Something happened where it's just because the sandwich is so big with the chicken.
It's because they put beignets on top of it in the bag.
And the beignets are doing beignets so heavy. Do not weigh anything down. Those things are like thimbles.
They're like little envelopes. We're gonna put beignets. Chocolatey goodness.
In between the chicken and the bun.
Well,
beignets.
And I remember very chocolate vividly. Chicken. You two fools. not fools, but you guys were praising. Like back in the day when the chicken whole thing was happening, and you guys were like, oh man, that chicken sandwich at Popeyes. And Jacob was like, did you get the spicy one, Kent? And Kent's like, no. And he's like, you have to go get the spicy
one. Yeah.
And I've tried the spicy one. I've tried the regular one. And these are good chicken sandwiches. I'm not saying they're not. So I don't want to disparage this as our number one because I think, you know what? It deserves to be up there. I just hate that Chick-fil-A was unseated.
Look, if I was anywhere and someone said, want a chicken sandwich, and if it was from Chick-fil-A or Popeyes, I would smile either way.
I would too.
Right? I would be as happy. I mean,
no, los dos.
No, I would, I would exactly. Immediately be like, do I want to feel good about myself or do I want a really delicious chicken sandwich? Like that's what I would decide.
Precisely.
Yeah. That's the thing. And so there you go. Our number one.
There it is.
Our number one sandwich. What was our top three, Jacob?
Top three is Popeye's number one, Chick-fil-A number two, and Zaxby's came in number three.
I'm okay with any of those.
I love it. I'm okay with this.
What's our bottom three, just for bottom, what to avoid?
Bottom three to avoid. Well, I'd say Wendy's. Mind
you would, but what would?
The group BaconScience says Culver's dead last, Arctic Circle, and then Dairy Queen came in third to last.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Special award.
Okay.
Here you guys are. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Jacob Twist.
Ooh.
Oh, it's been a while.
All right. Best budget chicken sandwich.
Like a low
dollar
quality
menu.
One?
Yeah. Like dollar menu. Well, if you got a cheap chicken sandwich, who has the best one?
Carl's Jr.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say Wendy's has a good hot and spicy chicken, too. Chicken sandwich. Little.
Do they?
I think a value menu one.
They have dollar burgers, but they just have, I think, the nuggets. Mm. Maybe they do.
Do you not have a cheap chicken sandwich you like?
They do actually. They? But Carl's Jr. is the best. It goes outside the bun, if that helps. But you also get the green chili on top, which costs 50 cents more.
Yes, and it's worth it.
It is worth it.
It changes everything, and that's amazing.
McDonald's isn't horrible either, though.
No,
that's what I assumed. That's what I assumed Joel's going
to
say.
No, my old go-to order at McDonald's was a spicy chicken sandwich and a McDouble. Like, that was my old go-to that I used to always get, and I still enjoy it, but...
Yeah.
Yeah. So there you go.
Healthiest award, Chick-fil-A. Actually, lowest calories as well.
That is lowest calories officially. So. And then lowest price was McDonald's, and Raising Cane's was way too much. And so was Shake Shack. Both those were the highest ones.
If someone handed me Raising
Burger King was the highest calories, though.
Yeah.
And I think we found out if it's not appealing to get a chicken sandwich after this, you'll probably want to get ice cream instead because a lot of these places
go to Culver's, go to Dairy Queen.
Yes.
Those are the
Arctic Circle.
Arctic Circle. Yes, that too. So there you go. Let us know what you think. If you've tried these chicken sandwiches, what if you think our rankings are correct? I mean, they're factual.
Perfect. Yeah.
They're factual is what it is now. But if you think the facts are correct or not, let us know on Facebook. Let us know on Instagram. Let us know on Twitter. We want to hear from you and hear your opinions on the chicken sandwich wars because we don't know when this war is going to end.
Maybe more people come up with hand-breaded.
Hand-breaded things, yeah.
Yeah, In-N-Out, hand-breaded chicken.
Hand-breaded burgers. Yes, but before we go, we'd like to give some love to our patrons, which includes our I Am the Listener category, including Sean Sanquist, Plot Twist Media, Lady Terry A. Finley, Just Plain Old Kyler, Jennifer Kokowski, Glow Clint Daniel, Chris Drought, Braden Winterton, Babs, Allison Gall, Alicia Bass, and Adam and Rachel Crump. And then we also have our Bacon Council, which includes The Shadow, Stephen Ross, Ryan and Marley Farron, our favorite couple, the Madsons, Nicole D. Kale, a sad Vegas Golden Knights fan, but still a fan, Matts, Chris Anderson.
Oh, Matts.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here,
Her Royal Highness Jessica Terry, and Reverse Listener. Thank you so much for being
patrons.
Oh my
gosh, there's so many people I love in there. I mean, like,
Matts actually went with me to Shake Shack,
did
by
he?
The way. Yeah.
Oh,
it was pretty fun.
Nice. That's good. And also, Glow is in there still, which is fun.
Yeah.
She's we had a class.
You totally should come to our next Baking Council dinner,
Jacob.
Yeah.
That's very cool.
But if you want to find me, you can find me at 76 Joel on Twitter. You can find me performing with Quickwits. They perform every Saturday night at the Midvale Performing Arts Center. For more details, go to qwcomedy.com or go to the Quickwits Facebook page.
If you want to find me on Twitter or Instagram, it's at Kenny3DD. If you want to read my movie reviews, it's showtimeshowdown.com.
If you want to find me on Twitter, you can...
You can.
You can actually tag me on Twitter, and I still won't know. Yeah, it's been muted for like a long time.
Has it?
I actually go in manually like once a month or two.
And check and see if you get notifications. If
there's notifications. And I feel really guilty when people have tagged me like to engage.
It's going to happen after this show.
And I just totally ignore. Oh, I should go on and check. Yeah. Fortunately, I've been kind of lucky. It's like I see within a couple of days and I'm like, oh, I'm just a little late on this. But yeah, you could find me on Twitter, I guess. Find me on LinkedIn. That's about the only social media I actually look at. So there you go. That's where I don't live there either. But
Jake, do you want to give our details for how they can support us on the show?
Oh, yeah. I'm about to. We would love to have your support on patreon.com. And there is a host of incredible opportunities to hear more content, to get swag, to hang out with the team, and to learn all sorts of background information about BaconSale. And it's very, very, very cool. So if you like the show, you want to support it, you want to help these very poor, amazing guys out, give them your money, okay? There's nothing that says thank you like cold hard cash, okay? That's what my mom always said, and it's still true. Also, you can support us by going to tpublic.com/baconsale, where you can buy merchandise and different things. Maybe there's even still a hashtag Team Jake in there. I don't know.
I think so.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, I think it's...
Did not sound convincing.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe there is. Maybe there's not.
Great job, Jake.
Okay.
Yeah.
How'd I do?
Great.
All right. And one other thing, guys. Thank you for having me back. I didn't know I was even replacing Zach. I thought I was just doing this thing, and you're like, oh, yeah, no, Zach's dead, so you should just come in.
Sorry.
I'm sure you'll bring him back to life. Kent's always doing CPR on him. So.
Yeah, it's your way. Hey, take it easy.
But yeah, it was good to be back, guys.
Thank you, Jake.
Thanks, Jake.
Yeah. It was really fun.
So until next time, stay hand-breaded, poultry pals.
I don't think I intended to do a moan impression.
Let's not talk about it, okay? It happened, and it's okay. Hey, do you know what's great? No, dang it. No, okay. All right, no, I got it this time. Okay. I got it this time. Okay.
Exactly. Only the stabbing. BaconScience only does stabbings. Boop. Joel research here. Popeye's like bringing your own bun. Jacob's bringing his own chicken.
Can you fry this up? Chicken.
Should I cut the head off now?
You want to kill it here, or do you kill it in the back?
They do the batter. I bring the chicken.
Okay. That makes sense.
Obviously.
That makes
sense. What are you guys been doing?
Can I get a kini for old time's sake?
Kini.
A little bit higher.
Kini.
There we go. I missed that.
Yeah, I bet you did. Carl, like it's a...
Carl? Who says Carl?
Carl.
Is
Carl
say,
is... That's two
do
syllables.
You say athlete?
Is that not two syllables?
Carl. Carl. No, that's one.
Carl. Carl.
Carl.
Carl. That's four syllables.
Carl.
Wait, Carl's Jr. Carl's Jr.
Carl's Jr.
With the
CJ's. Carl's Carl. Jr. Let's see if you can say it. Let's say it at the same time. You say CJ's. I'll say Carl's
you
Jr.
You can just say Carl's Jr. quickly.
Okay.
And you can say it.
Two, three.
Carl's CJ's. Jr.
We have a real itch for diabetes, guys. No.
Is Mickey D's one syllable?
Mickey D's.
Mickey D's.
No. Mickey D's. Carl's Jr.
Mickey D's.
You work really hard to win a game that you're the only one Joel. Playing that. Custard means quality. How would you like dirt in a bun? We fried it, don't worry.
Presentation is a big deal, by the way.
I mean, Arctic Circle never wins a presentation. We're about ice cream. If you want lettuce, it's going to suck.
So what are you doing? Get a blizzard.
Get a blizzard. Are you sure you want this?
There was a syringe in my sandwich, so we got low marks for that.
That's the kid's meal. It's a toy.
Welcome to 13th South.
I'm thinking Arby's.
It's the toenails, isn't it?
Not much flavor, but it's not a great flavor.
Nacho cheese. It's not my cheese. Jake.
And then I walked in the back room
playing cornhole. It was someone's backyard. I don't know. The dad in me loves Chick-King. Don't ask Burger King to go extra because they will.
He got to meet the devil and Kane in the same day. Wendy's, what have you done? Like a grown-up man.
No.
You spend the $4 and you eat chicken.
I was doing some Kent research.
So let's hear a research noise.
Kent, I don't know anyone.
The flavor is bland, but it's a good kind of bland.
This is a healthy chicken boy.
Can they hand me something? And I'm like, hey,
there.
Thanks. There. My pleasure. I'm like, oh, stop it.
Shut up.
No, it's not, you liar.
Quit smiling.
You hate your job.
We got toast.
Devil.
Chickles. Dang it.
Chickles.
Dang it. Hold on.
Chickles.
Pause.